So let's have a look on another concept under this problem solving as well. We're going to have a look on question 2, question 3, and as well, let's just discuss the 2. I think the 2 will be enough for the concept. I think that should be enough. Okay? So we're going to have a look on those 2. If I have to add something, I will let you know. Okay? So on question 2, they say we have a child which is swinging a ball at a specific mass, which is 0.012 kilogram. Okay? And they say on the horizontal, that's the information you need to pick. Horizontal, already you know what you're dealing with. And then they give us the radius. The radius is given, which is 0.1 meter. So the ball, the child was swinging a ball in the circular form. The radius here, it's given as 0.1 meter, and then the mass of the object is given, okay? But they say, the ball traveled twice around the circle. So we have the revolution which was given to us. The revolution is said twice. Twice is the same as 2. And then the time is 1 second. But the question is, we need to determine what is the centripetal force that is acting on the ball. Okay? So let's look here. I said the period is given by 1 over our revolution. And therefore the revolution is how much? It's 2, because it made 2 turns. So that'll be 0.5 seconds. We know, let me just even go further. I know that if I have to determine the centripetal force, it's gonna be m velocity squared over the radius. And then this is the same as max of the centripetal acceleration. So when I look it into my problem, I need to identify what is the unknown. I know what is the radius, I know what is the mass. So the unknown is the velocity, which means I have to look for the velocity. Okay? And then the velocity is given by what? The velocity, which is the speed, is given by mass. Okay? Sorry, in the circular motion is 2 pi the radius over the period. I come again this problem. I know the radius, but I don't know the period. And the period, I need to determine it from this equation. Because they give us 2 as a revolution, the period will be equal to 0.5. So when we come here, our speed will be equal to 2 pi times 0.1 divided by 0.5. And therefore, can determine our speed, which is 1.27 meters per second. After getting my speed, now I can come into my problem of the formula of the centripetal. So the mass is 0.012 times the speed, which is 1.7 squared, divided by the radius, which is 0.1. So I can get it's going to be 0.19 Newton. Okay? Really simple. So they say if the speed double, does the centripetal force double? If not, so that the factor does a centripetal force increase. It's really simple. So they say our speed double. What is the formula of our speed? Our speed is given by mass, okay? Sorry, 2 pi, the radius over our period, the radius over the period. So if the speed double, what happened? You're gonna have a 2 there, okay? And automatically, 2, the initial speed that we used to have, it was how much? 1.27, which is equal to 2 pi times what? The radius was 0.1 divided by the period. So the period is unknown. So we're going to get our period, which will be equal to 0.25 seconds. But our revolution is given by what? Our revolution is given by 1 over the period. And the period is how much? 0.25. And therefore we're going to get 4 as the number of turns if the speed increase. Simple. Okay? So let's have a look as well on question 3.3 and see what happened there, because they are also dealing in the same concept whereby we are in the horizontal. Okay, in our next video we're going to talk about the problem when you have a vertical circular motion. Okay, and then they say the earth rotates once per day. What happened there? We are given the time, huh? The time, which is the same as the period, they say once a day. So we have one day. One day, I mean, as 24 hours. Hour times minute times what? 60 seconds. Because our time should be given in seconds. And then automatically, if you do your mathematics, you're going to get the answer to be 86400 seconds to be our period at which our Earth is rotating. Okay? So this is our Earth. It's rotating once per day. Okay? And then, therefore, they say, passing the north of the South Pole in the axis that is perpendicular to the planet Equator. So the planet Equator, if you look at your geography, the equator is always here. Okay? And therefore, they say, assuming the Earth is a sphere of a radius, so they give us the radius of the our Earth, and then that radius is given as 6.38 times 10 power 6 meter, that's the radius of our Earth. And they say determine the speed of the centripetal force if the person is situated, the person is situated on the equator. Okay? So the question, we need to determine the speed and as well the acceleration when the person is standing on that ear. So therefore we're gonna have here, we're gonna have the speed is given by 2 pi the radius over the period. And therefore we have 2 pi, the radius is given as 6.38 times 10^6 divided by the period. The period is 6400, and as well here we're gonna get our speed to be 463.97 meter per second. Okay? And then we know our centripetal acceleration is given by the velocity squared over the radius. If you substitute the value, you're going to get the centripetal acceleration to be equal to 0.33 meter per second squared. Really simple. But now they say we need to calculate the same, the speed and as well the acceleration when this person is at the altitude of 30 degrees of north. So remember, you have your north, you have your south, you have your east, and as well your west. So if the person is 30 degrees of north, so the person moves that side, can you see? So we have a 30 degrees there, okay? So this person moves to that point, okay? So now what happened in this case when the person moves that side? You can see that our velocity change. So we need to determine what will be the velocity on that point, okay? The velocity on that point. So if you come here, if you look very well, you look very close, you have a right angle triangle. Whether this is 90 degrees, can you see? This is the adjacent and then the opposite. What will be the velocity on the adjacent? The velocity will be equal to what? To the velocity that it was given, sine, cos of 30 degrees. So you substitute the value. The velocity was given as 6.39 sine of a cos of 30. And therefore, you're going to get the speed to be equal to 461.01.81 meter per second. And then for the centripetal acceleration, will be the same. You just take the value of the speed divided by the radius. And that it. It's really simple and straightforward. So that's it about this concept. So you'll see them more often under your problem solving. So you just need to approach them like this.